It's another day in our revolution towards changing how we think about love and life. So I want to talk to you a little bit today about communication. You know, it's big. It's a big part of relationships, whether we're talking about a romantic relationship, about friendship, relationship with children, relationship with our coworkers, any relationship, which, by the way, is just two people. Okay, that's it. We're not talking about relationship status here, whether you're single, married, divorced, would like to be, whatever that relationship, quote unquote, status would look like for you. It's not what we're talking about. We're talking about two people that do life together. And that could just be anybody that you interact with on a day-to-day basis. So first thing we're going to do is take down that negativity about the word relationship, especially if you're not in a healthy one, a good one, and or you don't want to be in one and that word just freaks you out. This is about doing life with somebody else around us. That's your whole community. It's everybody you come into contact with. So how are we going to talk about communication today? My biggest thing that I want to talk to, I know I've talked about power of words and changing our vocabulary, and that's all very, very true. But your biggest challenge and lesson today is about listening. There's a really big difference between listening and actually hearing what the other person is saying. We've got to stop becoming these people that are thinking of the next thing to say, that are letting our minds run. We're actually disengaged. We've turned off the system inside of us that's actually paying attention. Yeah, we hear sound waves. We know there's that whole Charlie Brown teacher effect going on, that womp, 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 womp. But we didn't hear anything that the other person had to say. It's important. Have you ever had somebody that you're trying to explain something to, even something trivial, and they're just distant? You see the, like, the window shades went down in their eyes and they've kind of just taken off in another direction. Or big pet peeve of mine, and granted I have a long list of pet peeves, but this is a big one, is when you're trying to talk to somebody, they shut down, they move on to the next thing, or better yet, they just interrupt you mid-sentence and move on, as though they know what they think you're coming, what word is coming next in the sentence. They don't know. Last time I checked, they didn't have a crystal ball, they weren't reading anything, they don't have the magic eight ball getting ready to tell them what's going on. So, pay attention when somebody is speaking to you. Listen, absorb. It's okay to have a few seconds of silence after somebody has said something while you're processing and getting ready to say something back to them. If you're really unclear, repeat back to them. This is what I heard you saying. It will really help eliminate arguments and create a better level of understanding in your workplace, in your relationships at home. And so that's my big challenge to you, is start becoming a listener. Because what you'll pick up on, which by the way also includes paying attention to somebody's body language and all these other skills you can develop over time with it, is you're going to start picking up on what the other person needs. And you're going to see that whole read between the lines thing is really true. They may be telling you one thing, but they're screaming something else through the silence of those words, through their body language, through the actual words that they're using. Pay attention to it. We talk about creating this love revolution, this change of how we do life, and this is a critical one. You want to stop frustrating the people around you? Listen. You want to know how to take care of that person that's in your life? Listen. They're telling you. Even in the words that they're not saying, they're telling you. So be attentive, be observant, pay attention to what's going on. Stop thinking about yourself. You'll be fine. In the little moments of awkward silence, there's nothing wrong with them. It's you thinking, it's you processing, and it's you coming back with an intelligent response and hearing what the other person has to say. Stop pretending you know what's coming next. I guarantee you don't. Very, very rarely can you figure out what's coming next. You might be surprised if you actually open up your ears and, more importantly, open your heart to what they're saying. It will change the way that you relate to everybody in the entire world. It's a pretty cool thing. So that's the challenge for today. Go out, open those big old ears of yours, and do something good with them. See ya. I love you from your toes to your face. It's love.